Hi, I was just teaching a lesson to a student who was working on the second movement of the Ebert Concerto, and we were talking about the interpretation of the middle section of this piece, and I thought it was interesting and wanted to share some of my thoughts with you. So the second movement of the Ebert Concerto is so beautiful, it's so sentimental, it has a wonderful range of emotions. So there's no shortage of places to be very expressive in this movement. So, I was talking a little bit about the need to not necessarily be super emotional all the time. Sometimes we need to give the audience a little bit of a break so that when we do bring out that emotion, it has more impact. In other words, don't overdo it. So, this section at rehearsal 33, I think, is a great spot where we can pull back a little bit. Really, what's happening here is there's like a duet going on. And the flute is playing these steady 16th notes. And I like to hear this section where the flutist is not so much the melodic soloist, but more of the accompaniment. And we have this, I think of it as either like a keyboard playing 16th notes, da 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 dee dee da da dee dee da da dee dee da 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 dee da dee da 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 dee da 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 da. It's continuing, it has the perpetual motion underlying the melody that's also going on. And what's interesting about this writing that Ebert gives us here is there's such a range of harmonic color. The accidentals are all over the place. We know it's hard, and it goes in unexpected places. And we don't necessarily need to overdo it because the audience will hear it just as it evolves and unfolds. So, da 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 dee da dee da da. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm singing. I know, I'm not a singer, but sometimes it's easier to just demonstrate with this. So it's easy in this piece to think that everything should be expressive and that we should be stretching some of the notes to make them more expressive. I personally don't like that interpretation because I like to keep it as a simple accompaniment. So if we go da dee da dee da 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 dee da 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 dee da 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 dee da 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 da. Super emotional operatic melodic style. Da dee da dee da 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 dee dee da da dee da 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 dee da 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 dee da 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 dee da da da. I think it gets to be a little bit cheesy and a little bit too much, especially since the whole rest of the piece has these stretched out melodies where we do get to be very expressive. So I like to think of it as that accompaniment, almost like a bassoon. Do 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 dee do dee do 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 dee do 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 dee do dee dee da da. And then you get those do do dee do dee dee da dee da 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 dee do 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 dee dee do 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 dee da da. Then those colors, when they come up, those unexpected accidentals, they just sort of emerge, and it's really kind of exciting. Also, watch the D flats. Those notes like to be sharp on the flute. You've got to always be tuning those D flats as you go through this. And I'm paying extra attention to try to keep that dynamic at the piano marking, the piano dolce that Ebert gives us, and to maintain that throughout the whole passage, even as I sometimes go up into a slightly higher register. I don't want my dynamic to be changing too much, trying to keep it very atmospheric. So tell me what you think of this interpretation.